Thank you. We're especially pleased to have Regent Fate with us today as she completes her eight-year term with the board. Also, I'd like to mention that this is the 20th anniversary of Regent Usabelli's graduation from UAF. Please join me in welcoming all of these special guests. There are also some people in the audience that I'd like to recognize. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. First, Grace Scheibel, former member of the Board of Regents and president of the University of Alaska Foundation Board of Trustees, and Enid Cutler, the wife of the first chancellor of the University of Alaska Fairbanks, the late Howard Cutler. Our speaker today is a recognized leader and expert on quaternary geology and is also one of our distinguished alumni. He received his master's degree in geology from the University of Alaska in 1962, during which time he studied the ice dynamics of Alaska's Galkana Glacier, research that was supported by the National Science Foundation at the University of Alberta. Recognized internationally for his work in the geology of the Earth's quaternary period, the last 2.5 million years, he was the first Canadian elected to serve as president and Atlas Amino Stratigraphy, and for his lasting contributions to the state and nation, he will receive an honorary Doctor of Science degree during the ceremony today. Please help me welcome your commencement 2001 keynote speaker, Nathaniel W. Rutter.
Chancellor Lynn, Provost Reichardt, academic deans, graduates, family and friends. Let me say right in the beginning that I am more than delighted to be here, and I want to thank the University of Alaska for recognizing Wendell DeLone for this great honor. This has really given me the opportunity to reflect back on my career and how important the University of Alaska was in my decision to become a geologist. What may not be known, unless someone has scrutinized the archives, is that I was both an undergraduate student here as well as a graduate student. Let me tell you what happened. Well, I lived in Massachusetts and I attended Tufts University, England, as a student observer. It is a joint U.S.-Canadian resupply mission in the Arctic. And this is really another name for slave labor. But I remember vividly painting a number of boxes in bright colors, so never thought there was much west of Albany, New York, until you got to San Francisco. Anyway, so as my professor desired to become a geologist, it was really the frontier spirit, the openness of the professors here at the University of Alaska that helped this decision along. And one memorable person here was, some of people must remember, was John McCall. Now he was an Alaskan who graduated in civil engineering here, and he wanted to study glaciers and how glaciers flow. And what he did, he said, where should I go for this? So he got himself to Cambridge University in England, didn't apply, just kind of walked up to the door and banged on it and said, I want to study glaciers, let me in. Well, anybody that come from Alaska to Cambridge without applying for the university, they let him in, to say the least. Anyhow, he was the, in Norway, he actually drilled through a glacier and what he did was to set up strain gauges and other instruments. And anyhow, I returned to Tufts after my junior year and worked for an oil company for 3 years. Then I decided to continue my education and I returned to the University of Alaska for my master's degree. Really, my earlier favorable impression of the university brought me back here. And it was only, even though it was only 5 years later, there was a lot going on here. The Geophysical Institute was booming, buildings were under construction. The Bunnell building was one of them. And my old wooden dormitory had been torn down, I guess, previous 3 years or so. Anyhow, another reason why I came back is one of your professors, Troy Paywood, who's an outstanding scholar in Quaternary geology, and he turned out to be a lifetime mentor and personal friend of mine. At any rate, the following 2 years were probably the most important to me here. Lifelong friends were forged, and I'm very happy to say that some of them are here today. Well, what can I say to new graduates? What is important in life? What have I learned? Well, I can say without hesitation that you should definitely pursue the work that you enjoy. If you're not having a good time, you won't be successful as you could be. And that's a real advantage. It's a real advantage you have, both in the spoken and written word. If you can't get your ideas across, no one will really take you seriously, or at least you won't.
Will the candidates for associate degrees and certificates please rise? Regent Rogers, it gives me great pleasure on behalf of the faculty of the University of Alaska Fairbanks to present these candidates. Their names appear in the official commencement program for certificates and associate, baccalaureate, master's, and doctoral degrees. They have fulfilled all academic requirements for their respective certificates or degrees, and I recommend that they now receive those certificates and diplomas.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as a representative of the Board of Regents under the Constitution of the State of Alaska, and upon the recommendation of the Chancellor and faculty of the University of Alaska Fairbanks, and in the presence of your friends, your families, and your community, I confer upon you the certificate or associate, baccalaureate, master's, and doctoral degrees to which you are entitled, with all the rights, privileges, honors, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Congratulations, you made it.
Psychology. Terry C. Babers, Bachelor of Arts, Communication, cum laude. Michael Sean Bearclaw, Bachelor of Arts, Justice. Andrea Diane Bellis, 2 degrees, Bachelor of Science, Psychology, Bachelor of Science, Sociology. Linda Hernandez Bernal, Bachelor of Arts, Foreign Languages. Alexander Boyd Bettisworth, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Sculpture. Jessica Charlene Black, Bachelor of Arts, Social Work. Zachary Andrew Lurton, Bachelor of Arts, English, cum laude. Amanda Bowman, Bachelor of Arts, Journalism. Coretta Bradley, Bachelor of Arts, Social Work. Annette Lynn Brady, Bachelor of Arts, Justice. Erica R. Brown, Bachelor of Arts, Anthropology. Janae Carpenter, Bachelor of Arts in Art, cum laude. Tiffany Lynn Carpenter, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Tomechi Chukwu, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Misty Kosha Eddy, Bachelor of Arts, Psychology. Bachelor of Arts, Journalism. Bachelor of Science, Biological Sciences. Blake W. Larson, Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering. Steve L. McClurk, Bachelor of Science, Electrical Engineering. Justin N. Lindberg, 2 degrees, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, Bachelor of Science, Mathematics. Kevin Linebarger, Bachelor of Science, Civil Engineering, Summa Cum Laude. Amy is this year's recipient of the Marion Francis Boswell Memorial Award for the Outstanding Graduating Woman and the Gray S. Tilley Memorial Award, which is given to an outstanding non-traditional graduating senior whose education was interrupted because of family responsibilities, including financial hardships. This is the first time in the history of these recognitions that both have been awarded to the same student. Carrie Marie Topp, Bachelor of Arts, Biological Sciences, Magna Cum Laude. Benjamin William Venable, 2 degrees, Bachelor of Science, Statistics, Bachelor of Science, Biological Sciences. Jessica Warrior, Bachelor of Science, Mathematics. Tom Whitmer, Bachelor of Science, Electrical Engineering. Scott L. Williamson, Bachelor of Science, Biological Sciences.